If you are asked to give a regular expression to an automaton, then you can just have a look at the automaton and give the regular expression that way. But if you are asked to calculate a regular expression, or if you want to teach a computer program how to do it, then you may want to use this method. We can use this formula to calculate a regular expression to an automaton. And let me explain you what it means. R just means it's a regular expression. I is where this regular expression starts in the automaton, and J means in which state do you end, and K tells you that you are allowed to go through states up to that number. And going through is another thing than starting and ending. So let me give you an example. If you want to go from state 0 to 2, and you are not allowed, so K is minus 1, that means you are not allowed to go through any state, because there are no states that have a number smaller than minus 0. So you want to find the regular expression for the arc from 0 to 2, and you are not allowed to go through any other state. So what is it? Well, it's just this A. So another example, you are not allowed to go through any other state. You want to go from 0 to 0. And yeah, what is it? You want to go from 0 to 0, and you don't have a loop like you have here. You have a loop with those B, you just have nothing here. So what will those regular expression be? You start in state 0 and you want to end in 0. So what do you have to read? Well, you have to read nothing, and that is epsilon, and it means you just stay here doing nothing. So another example, you want to go from 0 to 0, but you are allowed to go through states up to number 2. You are allowed to go through every other state in this automaton, because the biggest number here is 2. So let's see, you could use this arc, but you can't leave state 1 anymore. Or you can use this arc, but here is again no way to returning to 0. So the only possible way, although you are allowed to go through every other state, is just the same as here. So just staying here. You are allowed to go through any other state, but it brings you nothing for this regular expression. So the last example, you are allowed to go through any other state, and you want to go from state 1 to 0. So what is it? Well, as you see, if you are in state 1, there's no leaving arc, so there's no way to reach 0, although you can go through any other state. So there's no way, and that means the regular expression, there isn't one, it's a empty set. So if you want to calculate the regular expression for a whole automaton, then you have just put the numbers for the whole automaton into this formula, and then you can just calculate it. Let me show you. I is our start state, so it's 0. And J is our final state, that is 1. And if you have an automaton with several final states, then you have to convert it into one with one final state first. So, and K is at the beginning the highest number. And this regular expression just means what the whole automaton means, because if you read a word with the automaton, you just start at the start state, at the beginning state, and you end in the final state, and you are allowed to go through any other state. And that is exactly what those regular expression mean. So yeah, now we just have to put it into this formula. So K is our 2 and k minus 1 is 1. We want to go from I to j. Then here again, k minus 1 is 1. Then you want to go from I to k, and k is our 2. And so on, again, r to the power of 1. And from 2 to 2. And from 2 to 1. And it doesn't really matter if you don't understand the whole formula at first, because you, at the end, you just have to put those numbers in and then calculate it. So, let's see what it means. This first part here, that is from 0 to 1. That is this arc here. You can are allowed to go through 0 and 1, but it brings you just nothing. And from 0 to 2, that is this part. Then you have a loop. And as you see, I constructed the automaton so it really matches this formula. So then you can better see what those parts are. And from 0 to 1. And that is its arc. And what those formula really means is when you want to go from one state to another, then either if you take out one state you are allowed to go through, then either there is a direct way from the state to the other, or there's an indirect state where you go where you first go to those new forbidden state, where you can have several loops as you like, and then go from those state you took out to the other state. And so this formula, so if this part would be a more complex one with more states and stuff in it, then you would just put those expression in those in that formula again and would calculate the parts of it again. So this formula breaks down your automaton until you only have single arcs where you can just read which symbol are at the arcs. So that means for this part of the formula we can already just read, so it's not necessary to calculate it to minus 1. This part is D. This is A. Then we have B and C. And let's not forget about those symbols. So, and that is the regular expression we calculated for, and that describes the same language as the automaton we were given.